Hey everybody, welcome back to yet another video. So today's 3-in-1 is gonna be muy caliente. I've cooked up some bomb outfits, my hair is about to be laid, and my makeup is about to be snatched. With all that being said, let's get started after the Bible verse. What I do to get your love? You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Psalm 23:5. GP, are you with me? These eyebrows are about to be snatched. You know why? Because MAC dropped the flyest eyebrow tool in the world. Give it a try, or don't. I mean, you don't have to take my advice, but I do recommend this stuff. I love the way I've been doing my eyebrows, and I'm taking it into 2020. Watch my tutorial, girl. It will show you everything. But anyway, next up is lashes. I'm using these Envy lashes in the style 1. I know the box said 19, but trust me, these are number 1. If you know I do my lashes first. That's just the way I like it, baby. You do whatever turns your turban. All right, so onto the face beat. I'm going in with foundation first. I did moisturize my skin, but I don't be doing all that extra stuff. I don't really need primer. Don't come for me. This is not a tutorial. This is a get ready with me. So I'm just being honest. Mind you, my makeup stays flawless all day. So what's good? I'm gonna go in with LA Girl Pro Concealer. And guys, this thing is $3. When I say to this day, I have yet to find a better concealer. Like high-end, drugstore, you name it. Look at that lift, come on. Anyways, I pair it with Too Faced Born This Way Concealer in Honey because of the color. I like the concealer too. They melt very well together. So yeah, it gives a long-lasting coverage. So now I'm gonna use my Studio Fix foundation from MAC to snatch my face and my eyelids. Give me the bronze, please. And this product blends like butter. I apply it to the outsides of my face to give that glazed donut look. Girl, you know that's what I love. And don't forget that double chin too. No more gobble gobble, Thanksgiving is over. I'm grateful for how pretty this makeup is coming out. Like, the blend is insane. After blending everything out, I'm snatched. I'm gonna go into my cream contour palette, use that yellow shade to just brighten the core slash center of my face. It's like being in the spotlight with no flashback. I love this step. I'm going to set it all with my girl Chanel in the color 2. She kicked Laura Mercier out of my mind. Like this powder, it's so smooth, airbrushed, flawless, very light on the face. I love it. While that's baking, I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyeshadow, and we're using Auntie Jackie today. This palette is so beautiful. Look at all those colors. I swear I'm still gonna use neutral color. I just can't help it. I'm gonna set my eyelids first though, so I have like a fresh base for my shadow, and then I'm gonna go in with Ginger, and she will be our transition shade. And the name is very fitting. Like, this is like the perfect bronzy matte color. I'm gonna go in with Soleil, and sorry if I said it wrong, leave me alone. And I'm gonna use that on my lid. I decided to be a little feisty and make or attempt a cut crease. Let me know how I did. You guys know this is my first time wearing eyeshadow, so go easy on me. Then I'm gonna take Zam and apply that to the middle and end of my lid for like some dimension. I keep laughing because I can't believe this is me talking about some eyeshadow, like for real. Anyway, I'm using Ginger to clean up my crease some more. I know what I'm doing, like at least I look like I do. And then I'm gonna take Credit and apply that to my outer V to like add more dimension and oomph, you know? I did pretty good, I'm really proud of myself, guys. I noticed this palette is really good for beginners. It blends so easily, and this is a beginner-friendly look, like you can totally do this. Back to the face, I'm gonna dust off the excess shadow and also all the baking powder on my face. Well, not all of it. I need some of it because I'm an oily girl and it's gonna help me out like throughout the day if it's just a little bit powdery. But I'm gonna take my ABH contour kit and use those brown colors. First off, with a lighter brown, I'm gonna set my cream contour that I did earlier. That's so cute. Sorry. And I'm gonna take this Morphe M222. M222. Yeah. Brush, very good for nose contour. Like, and it's affordable, so try it. Like, you'll thank me later. And I'm gonna deepen my contour with a darker, richer color using the 54 brush from Sephora. Because when it comes to contour, you know what time it is? It's the holidays. I wanna look grateful, warm, you know, wifey material. I'm gonna take some blush and put it on my cheeks and my nose. My nose? Yes. My nose? Yes. Then it's time to glow, girl. I'm gonna take my Amreezy Glow and apply that to my cheekbones, and this glow is making me jump from my chair. Nose, all of that. And don't forget the brow bone. Then I'm gonna line my lips with brown. That's the color. It's from Makeup Forever. All of this will be in the description box, by the way. Like, every product I used in the order used. This lippy goes out to all my nude lovers, because we know that all nudes are not the same. Gather around, everybody. I'm about to serve mascara. Brings the whole look together. Bottom and top, sultry, sexy, fall, everything. I'ma set it all with my Morphe setting spray and boom. Comment an orange heart if you're here for the makeup look. It's hair time. So you guys know I keep it very simple. This is gonna be a breeze. My hair is from Beauty Forever Hair, and I made the wig and colored it myself. Their links are down below in the description box if you wanna purchase their hair. You still have time for their sale. Use my code Sophiology to save extra money off, and let's work this magic. I'm gonna put the wig on so you guys can see what I'm working with here. Though I made and colored it myself, it was customized and installed by my girl, Slay Effect. I'll leave her Instagram down below, but she did not have to go off like this. Like, I don't know anybody sicker than her when it comes to lace customization. I didn't even have to put any work in to make it look natural. She just installed it for me and I kept it that way. But the bad thing about glueless wigs is it's a lot of gel, it's a lot of hairspray, it's a lot of stuff going on in the lace. So I'm gonna show you how to get it all out in minutes. I start off by spraying my lace with some water. This is gonna lift all those extra products out. And then I'm gonna take a makeup wipe and wipe the product off. It's really that simple. Like, you'll be surprised how efficient makeup wipes work with hair lace. And right before your eyes, my lace is clean. Didn't have to wash the wig, it's not soaking wet, it's just clean. Look at the plug job though, come on. Hello? What? She customized them. It looks like it's growing out of the mannequin. All that's left to do now is dry the roots, and that looks so good. A tutorial to how I colored the hair is down below, by the way, in case you want it. But just like that, my wig is clean and ready to go in minutes. I'm gonna take my big old wand and on the hottest degree curl my hair. I did it off camera because I didn't want this video to be too long. It is three tutorials in one, but you guys know I already have videos on how I get my hair together. I'll leave it linked down below for you as well. But I go ahead and lay my edges with Got To Be Glued, which looks amazing. And my stylist put me on to this olive oil setting spray. Oh, ooh, girl, holds everything together. Lastly, I take my generic hairspray and use that to hold my curls. It leaves a soft, brushable hold, and I love it. You guys know I've been screaming about this product. Huge, huge shout out to Beauty Forever Hair for sending me these bundles. Their links are down below, and my nails are complete, my hair is laid, my makeup is slayed. It's now time for my favorite part, the outfits. Introducing model for today, Sophiology. Oh, stop. I don't mind. All right, let's get to business. Outfit number one. One thing that I've been wanting to do. So if you're true to the game or whatever, then this looks pretty familiar. It's from my try-on haul, my Instagram. It's for the family, because I'm a family girl. I paired it with a bag from my try-on haul as well, and the black booties from that video. So yeah, on to outfit number two. Outfit number two is for my Instagram family. If you know, you know. But the skirt is from Fashion Nova. The shoes and the handbag are from Aldo. And the top is from Agassi. Got all these pieces a while ago. If they're still available, I'll leave them linked. But number three.
Yeah, I've been on tie, I've been on tea. Looking for girls in London. But they put me on a long team. Long team, I'm on a long team. But I've been making my money, chilling like Faji Alaji, falling like Maradona, feeling nice.
Yes, Sophie, yes. Outfit number three is serving bougie cousin. Now, it looks pretty layered up, so let me describe what's going on here. It's a black dress that I showed in my try-on haul as well, and I had to fold it up because it was longer than the coat, needed it to be the same length for aesthetic, put the coat on there, put a black tie around it, and added my little handbag. Voila, an outfit. You may not like it, but I do. Paired it with some Gucci shades. And yeah, I was a Gucci girl. Outfit number four, what am I saying? Outfit number four is my favorite. I usually don't tell y'all my favorite, but no. Sis came and slayed everybody. I got my JBW watch on. Make sure you purchase it. Look at that bussy. Use my code to save money off. It's in the description as well. But yeah, there was outfit number one. There was outfit number two. There was outfit number three and four. If you could not tell, I had a lot of fun making this video. Apologies for the tardiness. It takes a long time to edit. It does. 3 days. Anyways, yeah. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know which outfit was your personal favorite. Number four. Anyway, I did such a good job. Like, come on now. Give your girl some accolades. Comment down below. Subscribe. And, yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.